And after a grueling three-month fitness regime, Ricky Ponting believes he is primed for the Australian summer and beyond. Launching the cricket season in Sydney today, the former Test captain declared he's in the best shape of his life and is intent on winning back the Ashes next year.
I'd love to, and I've said that for a long time. I'd love to play Ashes series until I'm 50 years old.
Ricky Ponting's 38, averaged 100 through the Australian summer. You know, age is a number in my opinion. If you're performing well enough, you'll have an opportunity.
We certainly hope he's got plenty of hundreds left in him. The first test against South Africa is just 25 days away. Well, leading all-rounder Shane Watson is being hauled out of the Champions League, ordered by Cricket Australia to come home and rest up ahead of the upcoming international summer. Watson starred for the Sydney Sixers in their first up 14-run win over the Chennai Super Kings this morning. But it was Moses Enriquez leading the way, thumping an unbeaten 49 off just 23 deliveries.
This is an astonishingly good shot.
He then snared three wickets to get the Sixers campaign off to the perfect start, with little help from this stunning outfield catch from Steve Smith. That is a beauty. Now, as you may have heard earlier, Damien Oliver's riding career has taken a major blow after the leading jockey was dumped from two boom rides following betting allegations. The 40-year-old will no longer ride My Quest for Peace in the Caulfield Cup or Green Moon in the Cox Plate. The moves come after Oliver was accused of placing a $10,000 bet on a rival horse at Moonee Valley 2 years ago.
Of course you feel sorry for him. You know, we're all competitive and we want to beat each other on a racetrack and that, but we're all human beings as well.
And Williams has opted to accept the ride on Green Moon, while Corey Brown will replace Oliver on My Quest for Peace. Meanwhile, last year's Melbourne Cup winner Dunedin looks fit and ready to go for another spring campaign after turning heads at Werribee this morning. He dealt with some of the biggest scandals at the Sydney Roosters. Now, Chief Executive Stephen Noyce has been sacked. After 4 years at Bondi Junction, Noyce and the Roosters are parting ways after a club restructure. Noyce will be replaced by Brian Canavan, the man he succeeded in 2008. Socceroos veteran Mark Schwarzer is hoping last month's embarrassing loss to Jordan will act as motivation in Wednesday morning's must-win World Cup qualifier against Iraq in Qatar. The Socceroos have been in camp for a week, relishing some rare continuity on the training pitch. Schwarzer revealing he laid down the law after September's 2-1 defeat in Jordan.
Obviously, I wasn't happy, and I made sure that everyone was aware of that, and that we really need to take a hard look at ourselves. Otherwise, we're going to be looking at the exit.
If the Socceroos are under pressure, they're certainly not showing it, with Mark Bresciano happy to play class clown during Schwarzer's media conference. Novak Djokovic has put aside some serious frustration to exact just a little revenge for his US Open final loss to Andy Murray, claiming the Shanghai Masters title. The usually jovial Djokovic showed a rarely seen side of himself, his temper taking over as he lost the first set.
Oh, he's done too much with it. And it's all become a bit too much for Djokovic to handle.
The world number two regained his composure, saving five match points to deny Murray his third consecutive Shanghai crown. Play of the day, and unless you've been trapped in space all day, you've probably heard about the phenomenal achievements of daredevil Felix Baumgartner. The Austrian jumped from the stratosphere on the edge of space back to Earth, and with it became the first man to break the speed of sound. The jump wasn't without its hiccups, though. He briefly lost control, but pulled back to cruise down to Earth, and he stuck the landing with perfection. So for launching himself off a platform from nearly 40,000 metres and living to tell the tale, the 43-year-old has definitely earned our play of the day.